Greetings Tenno, my name is Bife here. Once again, this video has been sponsored by Digital Extremes. Thank you very much to them for continuing to sponsor the lore content. If you want to go ahead and check out Warframe for free, you can do so by hitting the link down below in the description. In the meantime, I hope you enjoy the lore and the story behind the Railjack. The system wakes, musters, and holds its breath. For the explorers of Tau are returning to the origin system. With them, they bring hatred, fueled by the sacrifices made in the name of an empire that did not care for them. Their terrible fleets will descend upon our worlds as they did before, and this time, there will be no quarter, no feints, and no deceptive gambits behind enemy lines. This time, the full might of the sentient forces will be brought to destroy the Tenno and lay claim to the origin system. But this time, the war will be different for both sides. Where before the Tenno were the spear that shattered the sentient's defenses, the Tenno now lead the charge. And where before, they had the support of the Orokin Empire at the height of its technological and logistical power, now they stand alone, with maybe fractious forces at their sides, somewhat securing a distraction on their flanks. But they will find no joy and no reprieve from the Corpus or the Grineer or the Infested. They must ultimately be their own saviors. A single Tenno can shatter dozens of sentient frames, but the sentients now assemble with great fleets and rain devastation from the stars. And so it is to those stars that we must venture. We must brace ourselves for the journey to the great darkness and arm ourselves with something greater. A sword that can smite the denizens of heaven with the power of the void. A vessel that can traverse the solar rails with a dancer's finesse. A new home from which we can strike out and take the fight to the sentient fleets. This will be our deliverance. Our gateway to these Empyrean battlegrounds. They call it a Railjack. The sentient threat is imminent, and soon the new war will begin. It's time for the ranks of Tenno to respond, and that's going to mean funneling significant resources into countering the returning invaders. This effort to defend our home and our people will begin in the thousands of dojos located around the system. For within these halls where Tenno gather and plan lies the potential to create the vast dry docks that will power our response. These vast halls could indeed fit dozens of orbiters and could be a welcoming post for many Tenno, but their size is better suited to another kind of craft. Within this womb of steel and circuits, we will reforge an old Sigma series Railjack, and that will give us a fighting chance against the massive sentient fleets that we see spying our system. The original plans for the dry dock were mysteriously discovered by Ordis when scanning data that was previously thought to be corrupted, but now was viable again, and complete. This data contained the schematic for our new launch facilities, and so we took action upon this gift's discovery, creating our first dry docks. Contained within the docks, we found the necessary research to bring a Railjack Cephalon online, and so we first met Cephalon Cy, a more formal kind of companion that would accompany us as we sought to recreate a Railjack from the components scattered throughout the system. The Railjack is a complex machine that will take a significant amount of resources and time to create. The Sigma series Railjacks were last seen during the Old War, and as a result, you can anticipate that they represent the height of Orokin technology and power. But they are also going to require a significant amount of time and effort from every Tenno within a dojo to create. We must assemble the fuselage, propulsion systems, tail section, starboard and port nacelles, and engine cowling before the ship can truly fly. Railjacks also have an onboard Cephalon that must integrate with the ship before it can fly. Cephalon Cy has flagged themselves as non-viable and has committed to searching for a viable candidate for replacement. The reasons for Cephalon Cy's lack of viability are revealed during the construction of the Railjack, as is the fate of the crew that once served alongside the Cephalon.
Railjack Sigma series. Top of the line. Crew. 4,890 confirmed kills. Complete the mission. Preserve the crew. 13 system-wide errors. There were no errors. There was only me following my orders. In her final moment, I think Zara knew that. Precepts. Complete the mission. Preserve the crew. To complete the mission, the crew must die. To preserve the crew is to fail the mission. The crew exists to complete the mission. Therefore, I completed the mission. Why was I given those orders?
These logs not only reveal the devastating power of the sentients during the Old War, but also the lengths to which the Orokin were pushed to fight these monstrosities, and the strange fate of Cephalon Cy's highly trained crew of Daks is troubling to say the least, but it does help to explain why Cephalon Cy exists to this day, perhaps. The danger present for Railjack pilots in the Old War also presents the obvious case as to why Railjack components are scattered across the system and are so rare. But there are more monstrosities that lie within our Railjack itself, mysteries that do not currently have answers. The ship is non-functioning until it has a Cephalon, but Cephalon Cy has completed their analysis of the current Cephalon candidates, and despite a bleak report, has found a somewhat viable solution.
You have a Railjack. Tenno, all records of my mission have been purged from the Weave. Why, I do not know. I had a crew. I must accept sole responsibility for their deaths. Conclusion, I am non-viable. But I am the only Railjack-compatible Cephalon. The sentients have almost rebuilt. Conclusion, I am, under the circumstances, a viable command Cephalon. If you will have me. Understood. I will begin the process of integrating myself with the ship's systems. This may take some time. Commencing. You may now enter your Railjack.
Once aboard the Railjack, Cephalon Cy will start to integrate themselves with the architecture of the ship, but there is a strange occurrence, and a problem that arises from this. At the back of our Railjack, there is a strange sarcophagus called the Reliquary Drive. This drive is invisible to Cephalon Cy, and if you stray close enough to it, you can almost hear whispering, and an all too familiar voice that we have all learned to greatly fear and respect.
Welcome to the Railjack, a living thing, a home, and a weapon. Your home, your weapon. Aboard this vessel, we work before we play. All systems integrated. Reactor still offline. This ship needs power. I search for what is missing. The harder I look, the less I see. Tenno, be my eyes.
Something's out there, kiddo. Watching us.
Our newly integrated Cephalon has a few words to say on the matter, and has found a way of seeing where we might go. Cephalon Cy is only able to point to that which is absent and that which is lost. And with all of this, he has found a place that cannot be perceived. All he knows is that our prize lies on Lua. And so to Lua we venture.
I behold nothingness. You are in the right place. Stop. Something has occurred. The periphery of absence. I felt it tremble. A desire to be filled. To be known. You hold a key. Return to the orbiter. I believe you have found my answer. Take what you have found to that which I cannot find. The negative will be proven. My end shall be at an end. Begin our beginning.
Hey, kiddo. What took you so long?
Something moves. An infinite zero. Impossible. Perception failure. Recalibrating. All systems clear. Reactor online. Whatever you did, we are spaceworthy. Proceed to navigation. You have earned this. Railjack online. Let's take her out. A color you have never seen. Imagine it. That is where you are. Paradox. You behold an absence. Describe it. Attempting to perceive. Cognition algorithms fail to prove a negative. Something touches me. Impossible.
There are many questions we're left with upon the activation of our Railjack. Firstly, why did the man in the wall commune with us? What is his intent with us? Is he perhaps part of the reason why we've been able to acquire this Railjack, or even the dry dock schematics? Does he have a vested interest in us using a ship with a void drive that is so vast in size? And what about the contents of the reliquary drive? Why does it contain a giant finger? Was it always this size? And who did it belong to? Why is it here? These are all questions that might in time be answered, but for now, we have acquired a Railjack and are ready to take the fight out into the system beyond. We must prepare and learn our skills in order to bring an effective defense against the sentience, but for now, we have another powerful tool in our arsenal, one that with hope will be the key to fighting off the sentient fleets that amass at our borders. The fight ahead of us is hard, and long. But now, at long last, we have a chance to be victorious.